web, and in this video we're going to finish off painting our troglodytes. And as you can see, the washes have dried quite nicely. They're quite pale, so we don't want to do them much brighter than that, but we are going to do a little bit of dry brushing. And the colour I'm going to be using for dry brushing is Avaland Sunset. I want something a little interesting. It might work, then again it might not. We'll find out. So I'll get some on our brush and move these out of the way, and then just gently brush downwards and pick out all the detail. And don't worry if you miss anywhere, it's not important to cover every little area as long as you get most of it. You can see we're doing this before we do any of the final final details, because we don't want to mess up the final details with dry brushing. There we are. So that's the that's the green troglodyte done. And we'll probably do the same with the other two as well, because it'll give a different look to each one. So yes, it's all the same colour of dry brush, but because the bases are different, it will look different. You'll see what I mean when we're finished. And we'll just keep going over. Oh yeah. Just like so. I'm just going to make sure if I have missed the feet on this one. And once a little bit more of this paint on our brush, we'll get some of the paint, dry it off on the paper towel, and carry on. It's a simple job. Anyway. And I've got now the same dry brush, but they all look different because of the wash that we placed on them. That's a very simple and easy way of making them look individual, but just by doing the same, just by changing one or two little things. In this case, it was just changing the wash for each one, and that's what gave. That's what gave the difference. Yeah. So there we have the whatchamacallit, the dry brush. Now let's get on with actually doing the armour. And for the main part of the metal, we're going to be using Stormhost silver. Reading the wrong line. Let's get some of that on our palette. And why have I used this brush? I don't know. So first off, we have the tip of the spear there. Then we have these two bands here, half part way down the shaft of the spear. We'll do that in the purple. Not purple, in the silver. Where the hell did I get purple from then? Next, I'm not sure whether this is part of the armour or not, but it does look it. We'll use that. We'll use it as if it is anyway, let's put it that way. Yep. Right, and now here. And we also have this part here to do. There we are. What I'm going to do is I'm going to wash this brush and I'm going to use a different one because this one's just a little bit too big for what we want. So we'll go into our slightly smaller brush. And just dampen it slightly just so the paint will move better. And we'll go over this area, which I am hoping is some form of armour. There we have a little ring there. And this bit over the shoulder. The silver will be dulled down a little bit by the use of a wash, but that's going to be right at the end of the process. And again, we have the little rings. Put way down the shaft. There we go. And the next one is just like this. And I've just realised I have missed a bit on the others, which is this part here. None of it looks as though it's part of the whatchamacallit, the troglodyte. It looks as though it is actually a bit of the armour. I may be wrong. If I am, doesn't matter. Just so long as the model looks nice when playing the game, it doesn't matter whether you get any some of the details wrong. All that matters is that it's nicely painted. As long as it's, any mistakes aren't too obvious, it'll be fine. So, there's the silver. Next, I'm going to go over the shaft of the spears on a couple of these just to tidy them up a little bit. Namely this one. do have some of the yellow that we used for the dry brush on the shafts. I noticed it more on this one than the others though. Oops. We can also take this opportunity to tidy up these rings that we've done in metal, make sure that they aren't too wide. Okay. There's one. I've missed a little bit on that one. Never mind. Can always go back and do it again. I just keep saying that's one of the joys of using acrylics. You can always correct any mistakes or any areas that you've missed. You can always go back and do them again. There we go. And finally, the green one. This is the dryad bark that we used originally. One I like using when I'm painting wood. Because, well, it is bark after all. There we are. That was the spear done. Next job is the leather strap. And for that we're going to be using Doombull Brown. So we'll get some of that on our palette. I'm just going to use this little brush because we don't need all that much of it. I'll pop some of that on the palette. Scoop some back in the pot. And then we can just go ahead and paint the area we want to paint, which is just this solitary strap. It's running diagonally across its body. There we are. And the next thing we need to do is the little crest kind of things that we have. Oops, slightly off the table, oh, sorry, off the camera, sorry about that. There we are. And just a little and so while we've done the dry brushing in like that darkish yellow, I'm going to use a pale yellow for the crest and the little bony bits. So we're using for this Flash Gitch yellow. We're going to pop some on our palette. Yeah. And just make sure we get a nice point on our palette, and then we can just go ahead and paint some of the bony areas like so. So it's the crest or the ridge on its head. On its elbow. spots that you can see in your raised bones. And it's back on his neck. And on the tail. The idea behind it is just a little bit of a difference in look to it. That's it, I think. And we'll do that with each one of these minis. Starting with the head and working our way down. We'll use, put some also on the eyelid as well. And we'll just move it on. Just like so. The in some areas you can, if you wish, do a little bit of a, not so much a dry brush, but use the edge of the brush just to pick out some of the ridges. Like so. There we are. And once again, top of head, I mean you can do these any colour you wish, I've chosen yellow, and you don't necessarily have to do all the same areas either, you can change them, do some areas on some of the models in this and leaving the rest of them blank, as it were, unpainted, well not blank but like for example the slightly raised area here. I'm doing yellow in this one, I've not done it on the others. I did down the ridges down the tail on the second one, but I'm only going to do the two knobbly bits, or the few knobbly bits on the end in this, and again I'm going to use it on the little ridges here on the back of the legs and in this one I'm going to do this part because I do not think it is actually armour, I think it is part of the of the blizzard itself. So there we are. The next job now is quite simply with Nuln oil. Once I get my brush cleaned, we get the Nuln oil and we go over all the areas that are silver. So as we say, it's Nuln oil. And just a little, in fact, I've still got yellow on this brush. I just have to make sure all the paint is off. Yep. And just go over all the areas of silver. It'll just dull it down a little bit, just so it doesn't look as bright. It's not, we're not going to go over this again to highlight it anymore. This is on now too. As I say, just to darken the silver part now. That's one done. And little rings, whatever this part might be. And finally this fella. And this will be the end of the videos for the troglodytes. I hope you've enjoyed these videos. Looking forward to getting them all finished and then we can start playing, because I don't like playing with unpainted minis. Except for certain games. But that is all we have time for in this video. So I hope you've enjoyed it. Here we have all three of the troglodytes. Let's go look at them one by one. We had the green one, which was the first one we did. And then there was the brown one. And finally, the blue one. I'm thinking, looking at them now, that this yellow is a bit too bright. So what we can do, just to dull it down a bit, using a little bit of Cassandra yellow wash. Okay. Again, you don't want a massive brush, but it's just a case of give it a quick going over. And just to dull it down a little bit, not too much. Just like so. It just makes a little more of a natural colour rather than being too bright. I'm going to do the same with this fella. And don't worry if you get it on any other part, it will just add to the look of the miniature. Give him a nice yellow-ish cast. There we are. And finally the green one. And that will be it for this video.
in fact I can actually go as far as just going down the entire back of this green one, just to give it a more individual look. Alright, but that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Can't do anything more with this now until the wash dries. So, until next time, from the three troglodytes and me, take care, God bless, and bye for now.